Hey guys, it's Thursday and this week's theme is letters to our past selves. I have a cold. Actually, I have flu. I got it when I got back from LA and now I'm just kind of miserable. LA was amazing. I flew on my own for the first time, like there with a layover and back without one. So I was pretty impressed with myself. That was my first time doing it. It was pretty cool. I went to Musso and Frank's, which is apparently famous, but I saw Hugh Laurie there, so it was amazing. And I didn't go up to him because he didn't really look like he wanted to be approached. So I just kind of did a casual glance back and saw him, which is cool. I saw my old babysitter from when I was 3, and my old neighbours, and my old house. Neighbours on the side of my house, and it was really fun, because I haven't been back there since I was about 4. We went to a bunch of other places, and it was really fun, and I enjoyed it. My blog of the week is Borrowed Blue Old New. I think I've already had her as my blog of the week under a different name, but I really like her. So you should follow her. She likes MCR, Harry Potter, Nerdfighters, everything good, just kind of scraped into one person who is Australian. So you should follow her. On to my video letter thing. Hey Abbey of a couple years ago. I think I'm going to start with 2007, Abbey. So right now you're pretty excited because you're going to have lab duties, which is fun. You should be really excited because it turns out awesome. But don't go to church the night they were born. No matter how much you want to see Hannah, don't go to church, because otherwise Mum will bond with the weird little curly one, and then she'll sell the one you like while you're at school, by accident, maybe, and then you'll end up keeping the weird curly one, and it doesn't turn out very well. So if you could stay at home and change that, that would be very good for everyone involved. After all the puppies leave, you will get your first computer of your own. Yay! You should definitely, when you get your computer, look up Vlogbrothers on YouTube straight away, instead of spending a year watching Harry Potter American Idol videos on YouTube. Just get straight to the fandom, because that is going to be your main life thing. For your teenage years, I guess. Go do that. Like, right away. Do it now. You're going to move to America, basically. In 2009, in September. And you might doubt me for a while on this one, because, you don't find out until like 2 months before you move, or maybe like 3 months, which isn't a whole lot of time really, to deal with that. So you're just going to have to get over it. If you could start packing like straight away, that would be great, instead of waiting until 2 weeks ago, 2 weeks before, like I did, because I didn't work out well and I still have a bunch of stuff on horse feathers that I would quite like. So do that. I guess the next thing would be if you could find MCR, My Chemical Romance, earlier. Not just like in the way that you found My Chemical Romance, because you found them years ago, but if you could like start really liking them sooner, so then you and Shannon can be twinnies all over the place while on the same continent instead of just on MSN, because I miss Shannon. And I would quite like to have a discussion with her about MCR IRL, because I've never been able to do that. Although 2009, Abby, I must say well done. Well, the amount of time you're spending with your friends currently, you don't actually know you're moving to America yet, but you do spend quite a lot of time with them anyway, which is good, which is really good, because I can't actually remember what it's like to be able to see your friends every day. So if you could save that a bit more, take a couple more pictures, that would be great. You think you're going to be able to spend more time with them? Like, kind of busy. Well, once the divorce is over, by the way, your parents get divorced. Well, then I can relax and hang out with my friends in my own little space, my own house. That's not going to happen. You're never actually going to move out of horse feathers, no matter what your mother says. That's not going to happen. So, yeah, you just have to deal with it. And we're going to move straight from horse feathers to America. So you have no relaxation at the middle point, like you thought you were going to have. So just get over it. As far as advice on moving to America, I don't actually have any, because I can't really tell you what worked and what didn't right now. All I can say is don't expect many friends, and don't have your expectations too high. Okay, well, I think that's it, Abby. You're on your own from there. I'll see you guys next week. Bye!